In this video, I'm going to go over these statements about the confidence interval for the population mean, and I'm going to determine whether they're true or false. Number one, a confidence interval that fails to capture the population mean will also fail to capture the sample mean. So that statement is false because the confidence interval may or may not contain the population mean, but it will always contain the sample mean because the sample mean is used to construct that interval. So the sample mean will be within the lower limit and the upper limit. So it will always contain the sample mean. Number two, a 99% confidence interval must capture 99% of the sample values. So that is also a false statement. 99% confidence interval just means that if we use that procedure that we use to construct the confidence interval, 99% of the time we expect to capture the population parameter. So it does not mean it will capture 99% of the sample values. Number three. For the same sample data, a 95% confidence interval will be narrower than a 99% confidence interval. That is true. A 99% confidence interval will be wider than a 95% confidence interval. So if that is the interval for the 99%, for the 95%, the interval will be somewhere in the middle here. So it will be captured. The 99% confidence interval will contain the 95% confidence interval. Number four, if a point estimate and upper limit for a confidence interval are 178.9 and 198.9 respectively, then the lower limit will be 20. Again, that will be false because if the upper limit is 198.9 and the point estimate, that is X bar, is 178.9, then we will have a margin of error, which will be the difference between these two, of 20. And we will have a lower limit, X bar minus the margin of error, which in this case will be this minus that, which will be 158.9. Number five, if a confidence interval for a population mean is constructed from a sample of size 30, that interval must contain the population mean. Now, that would be a false statement. The size 30 here is supposed to be referring to the central limit theorem, and what it says is that if the sample size is large, then the distribution of sample means will be approximately normal, and it does not say anything about containing the population mean. So that is a false statement. Number six, increasing the sample size will not change the width of the confidence interval. Now, we know the width of the confidence interval depends on the margin of error. So the margin of error is Z sigma over root N or TS over root N. So in both cases, as the sample size here increases, the margin of error will decrease because they are inversely proportional. So increasing the sample size will definitely change the width of the confidence interval. So that is also a false statement. Number seven. A point estimate is a single population parameter that is used to estimate a sample statistic. So that would be a false statement as well. A point estimate is a sample statistic that is used to estimate the population parameter. So we just need to switch the position of these two terms and the statement will be true. Number eight, if a particular 95% confidence interval captures the population mean, then for the same data, the population mean will also be captured at 91. So that would be false as well because 95 is wider. So if this is 95% here, and if we're able to capture the population mean, let's say somewhere here is our population mean, 91% could be in the middle here and may not capture that population mean. So that statement is false. If we switch 95 and 91, then the statement will be true. Number nine, the width of the confidence interval depends on the sample size. So that is true. We just saw that. The margin of error will be inversely proportional to the sample size. So it will depend on it. So if the sample size increases, the margin of error will decrease. Number 10, if a confidence interval does not contain the point estimate, then error has been made in the calculation. Again, since we're talking about the population mean here, the confidence interval will have to contain X bar because to calculate the confidence interval, we just take X bar and we add and subtract the margin of error from it. So X bar, which is the sample mean, which is our point estimate, in this case, will be in the middle. We have a lower limit on the left and we have our upper limit on the right here. So if it does not contain the sample mean, then there is definitely an error made in the calculation. So that will be a true statement as well. Number 11, increasing the confidence level will not change the width of the confidence interval. Again, that is a false statement because looking at the formula for the margin of error, which helps determine the width of the confidence interval, we have this Z value here, which is actually Z alpha over 2, or it could be T alpha over 2. This value here is determined by the confidence level. And the higher the confidence level, the larger the value of Z here is going to be, or the value of T is going to be. If we increase the confidence level, we will increase the value of Z or T, and then we will increase the width of the confidence interval. So increasing the confidence level will change the width of the confidence interval using the same data, of course. Number 12. For a confidence level of 99%, the left tail area alpha over 2 is 0.99. That is, again, a very false statement because the 99% is in the middle here. We have 99%. We have 1% left, so alpha is going to be 1%, 0.01. And if we divide that by 2, we will get 0.005 in each tail. So alpha over 2 will be 0.005. And that's it.